Tonight, voters are certainly making history.
And one political party can trace its history to a Wisconsin town. Tonight, Patrick Palantonio goes to the building where it all came together.
It's a very unique little place.
This little place is a National Historic Landmark.
The school was built in 1853.
It's home, Ripon, Wisconsin, where the 19th century schoolhouse is a 21st century destination.
I'm surprised we have as many people come from other countries to come and see this.
This is the spot where Wes Marquardt and his aunt Bernadette Split retraced their roots, a family tree that branches through this very building to a meeting that took place here in 1854.
And my great-great-great-grandfather, Amos Loper, was one of the original men here that signed the slip here.
Their ancestor is part of political history.
He's basically the scribe for the meeting and, you know, took the notes, wrote everything up.
The gathering brought together citizens taking a stand against the spread of slavery.
If you read the monument outside, you know, we went into the little building, Whigs, Democrats, Free Soilers, and we came out Republicans.
It became known as the birthplace of the Republican Party.
They made a vow to form a new party that would be primarily against slavery and carry this idea forward. We are against slavery. We're for the common man. We have a say. We're going to use our voice, our vote, to change the direction of where this country is going.
Over the years, the building has been moved to several different locations, settling in this spot more than 60 years ago. It's just a couple blocks down the street from its original home. The little white schoolhouse of today is a museum, opening its doors to school groups and tourists. It's been renovated to represent its original purpose as a one-room school and community center. And as you look around, you'll see signs of its political and educational past.
I'm very proud that I am connected with this.
A connection to a little building with a big place in history. In Ripon, Patrick Palantonio, WISN 12 News.
Now, the schoolhouse has no political affiliation. It is run by the Chamber of Commerce. And we should point out that other places around the country, like Exeter, New Hampshire, Jackson, Michigan, and Crawfordsville, Iowa, also claim to be the birthplace of the Republican Party.